discussing between p problem is pretty good. Everybody know it's a polynomial problem or tractable problem. And then the problem comes NP complete and exponential. These area you might be confused. What are those problems? Because what is ON problem? ON problem means finding an item in an array. Finding item in an array is ON. Push pop is O1. And in our regular grammar, you want to parsing a string. So you are giving a string. You know from the rules you can derive it. It's a ON. That is great, but it's linear. Then the comes. But the problem, you know, the regular grammar. One problem is that all the machines, finite state machines, are working in the 1900s, even beginning of the 1900s, 1930, 40, 50, all. But they cannot be programmable. So that the machine repeatedly acts in the same way. But whenever you have a power of programming there, then the machine becoming more of an intelligent. Now, for programming, you need loop structure. Programming, you need if-then-else structure. Programming, it needs opening brace, closing brace. So, this is the lacuna of the regular languages. So, if you can find, if somebody happens to find a Jacquard card. Jacquard card is a kind of a tool. You can print a hand loop shari in various Dhonekhali and area. That is also done by a little bit of programming by a pattern in the your sewing. So, but that is not programming. They are the fixed card. They are making fixed card, but they cannot. They change the card also. But you can say that is a little bit of programming. Jacquard card is one example. Then the programming great concept first come to the von Neumann. Von Neumann and Alan Turing together. They are basically colleague in Princeton University at the time. Alan Turing went there to Princeton to do a PhD work under Alan Zochart. At that time, von Neumann also there. So they developed the core computer, so whatever we are seeing today, till it is now a basic concept of von Neumann, so that your all addresses and instructions in a memory. The memory concept comes from Alan Turing. The same, the infinite block of cells. There is a functional unit that is called, we call the CPU, and that infinite stream of Turing machine now we called 6GB, 8GB RAM. So that's it. So what is there? All the problem in the P, but the first comes the problem of NP. What is basically NP? NP means you are taking always a lucky algorithm to get it correct. Okay, that is the problem. This is a this concept of non-determinism and NP is almost same. Like NP doesn't mean non-polynomial. Non-deterministically polynomial time it can solve, not non-polynomial. Okay, that is one thing. So that any machine can any moment of time take right guess, yes, and come to the solution. That is NP. If it is not, well, you are calling this algorithm is a lucky algorithm. And if you see the dynamic programming in your algorithmic class, the dynamic programming is another interesting case of divide and conquer rather than merge sort. The merge sort, you know, you divide the domain distinct chunk, divide by 2, then divide by 2, then you try to sort it and then you merge it. That is a divide and conquer by distinct division by 2. But in dynamic programming, if you do this in factorial and calculation, then they go take a small set and they derive it a solution. That solution is now they're taking over to other parts of the program. So that is a basically dynamic means it is a misnomer. It is actually that at that time the person who has developed dynamic programming, he is in the US Army, so that he should write this kind of things to camouflage his actual thing. So dynamic programming is basically a camouflage name. It is a divide and conquer, so that it can go to a small sum and then bigger it. But there, no non-determinism is there. But a non-determinism program, non-determinism is a theoretical concept. It cannot be done in actually. But then what is NP complete? NP complete problem, one interesting is, first of all, you get it at the right time. But if the solution, say, forget about it. If the solution is given to you you can quickly check it out in the polynomial time. That is a non-deterministic NP complete problem. Say, take the example of a chess. Say Vishwanathan Anand is playing a chess of, say, Bobby Fischer, the fictional. So in the midst of 25 rounds, somebody, Koshnoi or some other helper to help Vishwanathan Anand, say you give this move. But that checking of the move, whether that move is correct or not, you cannot tell it directly. So again, you have to take exponential problem. Because why exponential? Because every check piece can take 8 or 10 moves every time you are trying. So even if you are getting a solution also, then you have to check this amount of time. These problems are called exponential problem. They are much, much harder than NP complete problem or NP problem. So correctly, whatever we have in our problem domain, this is the P problem, the easy problem. Though it looks easy, all the sorting, searching, matrix multiplication, your minimum path tree and all these things, comes there, it is P. And there is one distinct notch is there, that this is the notch, this is called this is bound NP is there, but this region, particularly P, this NP complete, this is NP complete region, is very, very doubtful, because most of the problems are discovered either there in P or either like AKS algorithm by primality detection or either this. But what about this problem? This problem is around 3000 problems are there. There, all the problems can be reduced to our CSAT problem or click problem. I have discussed what is reduction. Reduction is very simple. If you have a problem X, but you cannot solve the, you can solve the problem if you can, another problem Y, that Y problem you can solve, then you can have a polynomial time algorithm. So that from X problem reduced to Y, so what are the inputs of the X? You are giving input, and whatever the output you are getting X, same input you are giving to Y, a same output you are getting as from X. So then it is two black box. Then if you want to solve a problem in X, you give the data to Y, and whatever the data is coming out, that is the solution of X. This is called polynomially reducible problem. So in computer science, whenever they find any problem, they try to match any problem, whether they can match it here or they can do individually there. So if it found it here, it has been found the various domain areas around more than 3000 every day it is discovering the problem is coming NP complete. The one of the first example of NP complete, whenever you are faintly parsing our context sensitive grammar, you see the parsing is NP complete. Context sensitive grammar is a type 1 grammar, you know, and before that context free grammar, non-deterministic context free grammar, it is ONQ, and deterministic context free grammar by various clever techniques by LR1, basically we use the LR1, we make it ON, parsing is ON. If it is not ON, it is very difficult to programming. And because we generally need unambiguous deterministic context-free grammar. But whenever context-sensitive grammar, it is NP-complete. NP-complete means is huge. It might need huge amount of time. So that is the reason you can find that hardly context-sensitive grammar rules in the any programming languages. Then comes this is context-sensitive grammar is a type 1. Then comes the type 0. The type 0 first part is Turing decidable or recursive language. There it is, all problem comes are more than NP complete. It is exponential problem. It is exponential problem. And then comes the type 0 recursively enumerable language or Turing recognizable language. Much, much tougher than type 0 Turing decidable recursive language. So there is a problem is exponential, and sometimes exponential means is go like this. Remember, all exponential problem, another problem you might get it, that is a traveling salesman problem, where you have n nodes and how many ways you can go around. It is a factorial n, factorial definition, but factorial n can be converted to this one, 2 to the power n C. C is a constant. Remember, C is here also there. Your polynomial problem basically nothing but O in C. C is a constant. Okay. It may be C is equal to 1, 2, 3. Generally, I have found only C 1, 2, 3, and there are logins are there. Remember, any problem comes O login here. What is the problem? This is login to the base. Can you tell me what is this complexity? Complexity is exponential, because though this term is small, but n goes to the power. So this is exponential problem. We can find like one login problem, you know, binary search tree and merge sort and heap sort, you get n login, but here the login comes to the your index. Okay, so coming back, so this is the NP complete, then comes the exponential here. Exponential example is 8 by 8 chess. Like I told you, in a movement, chess movement, you cannot, even if you have given the solution, it is difficult to check it. So that is exponential Tower of Hanoi, I have told you. Then comes our, beyond that exponential, then come the actually complexity goes on. Okay, then the best example is Turing halting problem. Turing halting problem, you know very well, but I am telling it once more. What is Turing halting problem? Turing halting problem is basically answers to Hilbert 10th solution. I have said that you cannot design a program. You cannot design a program all time, not all time, that it takes any input and tell that program will stop or not. Okay, but again I am rephrasing. You cannot design a program which takes any input program and its input data and decide that it will definitely stop or it will definitely halt or not. So this is, you cannot, because it is what he says, the whatever program you write, it is basically, you convert it to a dot out, it is actually a binary string. Any exe file is basically 110001, it is a binary string. This binary string, if you convert to a natural number, it must be a natural number. It may be a huge natural number, maybe 1 million something, a natural number. Any program, can map it to a natural number. This program, whenever the data is coming, it will write it, either halt it yes or no, 10110, like this. So if this program, you know, whenever you give a data, whether they accept or reject, accept means 1, reject is 0. So if you then any program you write it is a natural number, and output is, if you think of a decimal point, I am telling you, decimal point in front of that output, this is basically a real number. Your output is a real number, because 0.1001001, it is what is it? It is not a natural number, it is a real number. Now you know two kinds of infinity. One is smaller infinity, one is bigger infinity. Your natural number is a smaller infinity. So your program comes from smaller infinity, and your output is coming from a real number which is bigger infinity. So you cannot map 1:1 to natural infinity to real infinity. So that is the reason it is not possible. It is one way of logic, subturing halting problem. There are another way you can solve it, that it is not possible. Another great thing is this 3000, this is the NP complete problem, where our context sensitive parsing is there. The best example is the factoring problem. I know which I hope you know Michael Sifter's lectures, he discussed about 13/7 equal to 91. Whenever you ask 13/7, you can quickly come 91, but whenever you see 91, it will take some millisecond. And if you two big prime numbers, big means say 3-digit big prime number, another 3-digit prime number, it is a, you need a computer needs say only fraction of a second, but whenever the computer is giving that number and tell it the factors, computer may little more amount of time. And if it is a 309 positions, and if you tell the computer to factorize, computer will take 100 years. So that is the basic things of all our security, because everywhere you see the security protocols, anywhere, they are depending on the prime numbers. Prime numbers are unlimited. True, prime numbers are unlimited. It is free. Product of two big prime numbers, if you are given, if you do not know the factors, if you give somebody to product of two big prime numbers, very, very difficult to find it out. So that is the basic pillar of security, of all the security what I'm saying. Our basically RSA algorithm all depends on the prime number. So this factorization problem is a NP complete problem, because whenever you're given the answer that these are the two factors, you can quickly check it. Yeah, it is. So what is an NP complete problem? In summary, NP complete problem are not the very toughest problem. The toughest problem, we know, the exponential problem. These are the problems that are the more toughest, and polynomial is the easiest. NP complete problem is finding, if you have got a solution, checking is pretty easy in polynomial time. That is NP complete problem, and that is interesting. Why it is interesting? There is a $1 million prize is there, so all the great computer scientists still working on it, whether P equal to NP. So this is the P, this is the NP, whether this area is there or not, nobody says. Particularly this area, what are the things, some of the problems are here, the people are putting it here, either here or either here. This area might be collapsed. Same is here, NP complete and between exponential. And these are the things. So these are the our complexity scenario. And quickly, this is the NP hard. NP hard means you cannot verify. This is NP complete. This is P. These areas are there or not, because any problems are there NP, it can be here. So there are some problems still there. It is some problems are still there. Whenever you see the NP problem, and say it was taking the taking the lucky algorithm. It is always take the at the first chance. This is lucky. It is not exhaustive. So this is the bedrock of non-deterministic solution. So it always find lucky. Then it is called NP problem. Okay. So this is hypothetical. But if you found solution, you can check it. And if you find everything, you are not lucky, then it is not solvable. This is the graph. Same graph I told. This is a halting problem at the rightmost. This is a chase problem. I have told you most decision problems are uncomputable, because every problem you can put it in a decision problem. This is a complete graph. Because every problem generally you put it in a graph. In the formal language, automata, anything. But the graph is a basic input structure, and graph can be represented various adjacency list and all this way. So graph is a very favorite medium to put all problems. This is a complete graph, means all are connected to each other. This is a complete graph. This is a click. The click means they are connected with each other. This is a red arrow and a click. And this is also independent set that I have covered. Independent set means in a graph, you can see the nodes which are not connected to each other. Like here, reds are not connected. We'll see that this independent set and click and cover set, they are all basically the same problem. That is great. So there are they are all NP complete problem, but they are basically same problem. If you can find it one solution, you can find it another. So we can see it right now. So here in this area, this is the graph. This is 1, 2, 3 is a click, and 1 and 4 is your independence number. This is a whole graph. This 1 and 4 is independence number, and 1, 2, 3 is a click. This is the example. What is click and what is independence set? Because they are very crucial. This is a click and independent set, and a click in a graph, independent set, a graph, a set of pairwise, not like here. This is a graph. This area, this is a click, and U and W are only the independent set. They don't have any common connection. U and W. These are the click, and U and W is the independent set. Here is very interesting. Please look at it. Very interesting. See, this is a graph. So this is a graph, and these red balls, red graphs are independent set. Now you make this graph as a complement. What is the complement of a graph? What is the complement? So, what are the edges are there? You delete it, and what are the edges are not there? You put it. So there is no edges. You put it. So I put it these edges, and whatever the edges are there, I delete it. This is the complement of this graph. Now I see this independent set are nothing but click of this complement graph. So that is beauty. In graph theory, you know the independent set of a graph, and you make the graph at its complement. What is the complement? Complement means if the nodes, is there any edge, you delete it. If there is no edge, you put it. Then the whatever the independent set you get it at original graph, it now becomes a click. So now this is the relation between click and independent set.